James White is an African-American student from a single-parent home who qualifies for a free lunch and breakfast at school. All that is to say, he is in a demographic where the odds of academic success are stacked against him. But White is beating the odds.
I want to go to college, major in civil engineering, hopefully one day become the CEO of one company.
White is a senior at McKinley Technology High School in Washington, D.C. He started school as a B and C student, and now he's getting A's and B's in his honors and AP classes. What's even more remarkable is that White is not the exception. McKinley's student population is 98% minority. 6 of 10 qualify for free or reduced lunch. But most important, 92% of the students are proficient in math and English.
In spite of the fact that we've increased the number of students at the poverty level, we've exponentially increased student achievement rates.
David Pinder has been a principal at McKinley since 2006. He asks three things from his teachers.
I call it CPR, the lifeline to great teaching. That they are experts in their content, that they're experts in making pedagogy for kids of all different levels and all different learning styles, and that they're experts in relationships.
Is it working?
Christopher Grimm is an engineer turned teacher. He teaches STEM classes, that's short for science, technology, engineering, and math. He says he's teaching White and his peers to be future engineers by doing as much as showing.
How else are you going to learn? And go ahead, kids, play with it, try and see what happens. It doesn't work, okay, why didn't it work? And all that. Yeah, sometimes it frustrates the kids, they don't get the pat answer that they want right away, but it's like, I want you to figure this out. This is how you think, this is how an engineer thinks.
It's getting them to buy in and kind of showing them where the things you're learning in math class can tie into the real world and giving them examples that actually mean something to them.
For math teacher Shira Fishman, building trust is as integral as practical skills.
I just never bothered doing them on the homework.
I got A's on the quizzes.
That's a lesson.
Yeah. I mean, I say all the time, I feel like I'm, you know, a teacher and a counselor and a big sister and a cousin, you know, and I take pride in that. Like, I want the kids to feel comfortable to come talk to me about something that may have nothing to do with a proof in geometry. And then when they trust you, when you give them a really hard problem to do, they're like, all right, Ms. Fishman's not going to let me fail. Like, if she thinks I can do it, then I can do it.
She's taught senior Malik Harleston for 2 years.
Like, I come here to talk to Ms. Fishman about everything, football, basketball, girls, everything.
He now plays basketball, football, and is a member of the poetry club. But by his own account, he did not take classes seriously his freshman year.
They knew I had potential, and they know I wasn't showing my full potential, but they pushed me to bring my full potential out.
That push by teachers to expect the best seems to be paying dividends. It wasn't always the case. McKinley High School was closed in 1997 due to low enrollment and declining academic performance. It later reopened and transitioned to a STEM school. In 2006, there were 180 applicants to McKinley. This year, according to the principal, they expect more than 1,000.